In this lesson, I will show you how revolution operation works. This operation allows you to make a solid from a sketch by rotating the sketch. Please subscribe to the channel and continue the lesson. We can create 3D models based on a sketch in the part design workbench. Select this workbench and select new file. And first, let's create a sample sketch. Select create sketch and select XZ plane. What you may notice is that we have switched to the sketcher workbench, and this is where we have to sketch tools and we can create the geometry. First, click here and make sure you have the same options as mine, and we will draw a shape consisting of several lines, and when it comes to drawing lines, we can do it with the command create line or create polyline. As for the create line command, it works in such a way that we indicate two endpoints of the line, and after drawing one line, this command is active and we can draw another line. And in this case, we draw separate lines, and if you want the lines to be related to each other, then when drawing the next line, move the cursor to the end of the previous line, and when this point is highlighted, click left mouse button. And thanks to the automatic constraints, the endpoint of this line and the start point of this line have been connected. And you can enable or disable automatic constraints here. Okay, right click to cancel this command and select all the geometries. Just left click and drag a selection box over all geometries and press delete. This was one way to draw lines and will work well for drawing single lines. But if you want to create a shape consisting of several lines, it may be better to use the create polyline option. This option works in such a way that after drawing one line, the end of this line is the beginning of the next line, and all subsequent lines are connected. Cancel this command and delete all geometries and select again create polyline, and let's draw sample shape, for example like this. And notice that when I moved the cursor over the x-axis, it was highlighted. And now when I click here, the point of this line will be connected with the x-axis. Okay. Draw something like this. And right-click to cancel this command. And now let's add dimensions. Select constrain vertical distance and select this line and enter here 50 millimeters. Okay. The command is still active. Select this line and enter 25 millimeters. Okay. Right click to cancel this command and now select constrain horizontal distance and select this point and the origin point and enter here 10 millimeters. Okay. Now select this line and enter 10 millimeters. Okay. And select this line and enter 20 millimeters. Okay. Right click to cancel this command and now select constrain equal and select this line and this line. And this constraint make these two lines equal. The sketch is green now, and it means that the sketch is fully constrained. and that means we can't freely change the shape and dimensions of the sketch. If you want to change something, you can change the dimensions or constraints, but you can't freely change the sketch. Okay, click close to finish sketching, and now based on this sketch we will create a 3D solid by rotating the sketch. Select revolution command, and in the preview you can see how it will look like. And when it comes to the revolution operation, we have two important parameters here. The first is the axis of rotation, and the rotation will be performed about the selected axis, and a 3D solid will be created on this basis. You can select a sketch axis, coordinate axis, or you can specify geometry as the axis of rotation. In this case you can choose, for example, base Z axis. And the next parameter is the angle. In this case the value is set to 360 degrees, which means a full angle, and the sketch will simply be rotated 360 degrees. And you can enter a different value here, for example 200, and the solid will look like this. Let's go back to 360 degrees. Okay, and click left mouse button outside this box to update the view, and click OK to accept. This is how the operation of creating 3D solid by sketch rotation works. This is one of the basic operations of creating 3D solids. Now you can add another 3D solid creation and editing operations on this model. Just because you use one operation to create a solid doesn't mean you can't create another. And select this face and select create sketch to create another sketch. Now select external geometry and select this circle. Now this circle is an auxiliary circle, and this is the reference geometry to the solid created in the previous operation. Okay, now select create circle and draw two circles. And to constrain these circles to this geometry, we are going to use constraints. Select this point and select constrain coincident. And now the centers of circles are coincide. Now select this circle and this circle and select constrain equal to make both circles equal. Now select the center of this circle and this point and select constrain coincident. And select constrain diameter. Select this circle and enter here 35 millimeters and click OK. Click close to exit sketch, and now you can add, for example, path operation, and you can create another fragment of the 3D solid. Okay, and you can add more sketches and more features to create more complex 3D solids. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to this channel.